guys, today is going to be a review on the DJI Osmo Mobile. I have no idea what this thing is capable of. We're going to find out together. You guys, stay tuned. Enjoy the footage.
Samson, come on.
I came down to this spot. I used to hike around a lot, and I found a door. See if I can. Right there. It's a freaking door. It was laying on the ground. So I set it up. And we're gonna make a cinematic shot.
This active tracking is not working. It keeps saying not available in this mode, whatever that's supposed to mean. Okay, so since it's raining, try the active tracking. Circle my face, and there we go. So yeah, it just lost my face. And it says it's searching. My face is right here. There, it picked me up. And it lost me again. Let's just do this. Boom. Okay, so we're back in action. It's following my. Let's circle my face. Okay, looks like it's on. So, yeah. I don't know if I'd use this much, but hey, if you guys wanna. Okay. This actually, see how far back it'll go. Yeah, looks like it just lost me. So if you look away from the, I'll have to step back inside the square and it should pick me back up. There we go. So, there. This is bad. There's a lot of stuff to trip over.
Thank you.
That'll be it for my product review on the DJI Osmo Mobile. Basically, what I've found out about this thing in the past 3 days of playing with it is that it is worth the $300, and it's worth the extra $100 compared to its competitors. I mean, this is DJI we're talking about here. They make killer drones, and I mean, they can handle a simple phone gimbal. This thing does the motion time lapse and the hyperlapse. I mean, the software that they have that became the app that you download for this gimbal is awesome. Works super smooth. The only downside is that it doesn't shoot in 4K, which was kind of a bummer deal, but you can have other apps running while using this gimbal. You don't have to just use the DJI Go app, which is perfect. Once I found that out, I was sold on this thing. It was awesome. So if you guys have other video camera apps that you would prefer over the DJI Go app, that's fine. You can still use them. Now, as far as the tripod goes, I use this ProLine tripod that I bought for my DSLR off of Amazon a few years back, and it works perfect for this thing. Because of it having this pivoting head, it's able to mount onto the side of the gimbal, and then it's got this quick connect, which makes it easy to put on and take off. There you have it. I just leave it on here at all times, because then when I want to mount it to a tripod, it's just there, ready to go. It doesn't thread in all the way. I don't know if you guys can tell, but there's a bit of a gap because of the slant in the handle and then this mount being flat. You're maybe losing a couple of turns, but it's still, at least it's tight enough to where, you know, I could tell at least that it wasn't going to fall off. I trusted the fact that it was there and it wouldn't fall off the tripod into the creek. That's all I got for now, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video, and subscribe to see more videos I'll shoot with this thing and just stuff I do out and about. Thanks. Bye.